So Bleach Soul Resonance dropped a new trailer and we're going to get right into it, what my thoughts, my expectations are, a little bit about some Q&As from you guys about what I know and what I can potentially tell you, and just overall talk a little bit about this game before some more news potentially comes out in maybe less than a month or maybe more, who knows, before the beta test comes out and everything you need to know. So if you like this type of video, hit that like, that subscribe and all that good stuff, and let's get right into the video. So if you guys don't know, there is a hit new game called Project Blade. Sorry, I mean Bleach Soul Resonance. It is a new mobile game. Yes, I know. Don't complain in the comments about it not being a console game, because it may come on the console. Who knows? So checkmate. But regardless of that, Bleach Soul Resonance is being dubbed by Newverse, and we got a new trailer post the alpha that some may or may not have played. And I will be talking about my experience through the alpha going into the beta that is going to be coming out extremely soon. So I really can't wait for you guys to actually sit down and play this game. But in regards to the trailer, as you can see it on screen right now, we have our four main cast of characters. There is no Rukia. I assume that any trailers that come later on, which I do know maybe what's going to be happening in the trailer, maybe, who knows, this is focusing on the four main characters, and then we may get more later on. I don't truly know, but again, we'll figure that one out together. I was teased slightly that I would like this one more than this one for some reasons, and you may know that reason when it comes out. But what we have here is the four main base characters of Ichigo, Uryu, Chad, and Orihime, and showing off what they can do, as well as some mechanics such as the block and dodge mechanic, which there was a few questions about that we'll get onto very, very soon. And all I can say is I'm extremely pleased, especially in regards to Chad and Orihime. For those that played the alpha, Ichigo was really fun to play at base. And of course, Orihime and Chad, I felt, were a little bit lackluster, and not maybe for the fighting style, even though it has looked like it has been revamped, which is really fucking cool. But I'm wondering more so, has their usability gone up since the alpha? And that's the important thing that I will be looking at when going into the beta of this game. So, from what you can see from the footage, is the dodge mechanic, more so the Fugetsu block, and I really hope they have changed that name, because I wasn't really a fan, but hey, you get used to these terms in general. As you can see, each character has their own individual style when it comes to making these dodges, and also their own characteristics of how to counter as well, and you get a little bit of what their moveset is going to be, and you have to take into consideration that these characters are at their base levels. So the fact that these look really cool and really flashy and really enjoyable to play as a moveset makes me all the more excited to what it's going to be when they show something like maybe Bankai Ichigo or Shikai Ichigo, because, you know, Shikai Ichigo, I ain't gonna lie, when I played it in the alpha, was so fun. And as I said, each character has their own uniqueness to it, and Orihime is looking really fun, even though she's a defensive character. So, I'm very excited to play her again to see what improvements have been made. You also get a glimpse of the graphics as well. Now, of course, I have seen a little bit of critique about this trailer being a bit low FPS. And yes, that is an issue. That is actually only to do with the video. This will not be like that in the gameplay. It was noted. I did talk to the team. And this is an issue that is known. So don't worry about how the FPS looks, or if it looks chunky or choppy or not, because that is just in that video purely. Don't worry about it. It's still, again, that's in development. It's been noted. So I want to talk about the most important thing about this in general, is that there is a pre-registration. So before I get into the Q&A of things of what I think I may or may not be able to talk about, I'm not quite sure, let's talk about the pre-registration, because this is important. Now, China have already done a madness with their pre-registration, and now it is the West's turn in doing so. So what you're going to need to do if you want to play this game, if you want to play the beta, if you want to get involved, what you're going to need to do is go to the front page of the website. There's going to be a link in the description down below where you're going to put your email address, and to help us get some more bonus rewards. And of course, you know, if you fill out the survey and you may type in my name, maybe you might get some extra. Who knows? Who knows? Or your favorite content creator, such as maybe someone like Aaron. Maybe. Who knows? But what you're going to want to do, website, go sign up, be a number, add onto that big pre-registration, and we can finally get some good rewards for you guys to check out. Get loads of summonings under your belt, get a taste of what the game is going to be like, and as well, a lot of soul tickets as well, which I know is named different, and I don't know off the top of my head, because I can't visit the website because it's blocked by Japan for some reason, but that's besides the point. Go over, sign up, important. Let's beat China. Probably not going to happen. But hey, the West is stronger. I know the Bleach fandom is strong as well, so we can do it. You know, there was a time where we didn't have any Bleach games at all. So show Shueisha, show Newverse, show the market that Bleach is here to stay. And there is a fan base that is willing to play and support this game. So before I give my two cents of what I think about this game, which I'll probably do in another video, let's talk a little bit about the Q&As. Now, if I ignored your Q&A that I wrote on Twitter, there is a reason that either it is the same question or it's something that I don't really know how to answer. So first and foremost, will this game include the whole Bleach lore? I mean, Arrancar, Fullbring, and Thousand Year Blood War arcs. Good question. The answer goes as far as the Bleach community supports it. This is within the Thousand Year Blood War style, as you can see from the trailer, and that is a big incentive, especially if I had to really sell it to you guys. You will experience the Bleach kind of lore or the Bleach story in a way that you've never experienced it before, and that is a really incentive thing, especially with the cutscenes. They look absolutely gorgeous, and I can't wait for you to experience it in a whole new light. So to answer your question, support the game and you'll get the result that you may desire. How frequently will we receive new characters? Will it just be a one character each month, or can we expect more? I don't know. That is a simple answer. I don't know. From my expectation, I personally think it may be two a month, but I couldn't really tell you. But that's what the game is focusing more on, is gameplay over the gacha system as a whole. And that's really important because the gameplay is really good, especially when it comes to dailies, when it comes to quests, side quests, stuff like that. So I couldn't tell you really how many characters there is. And then of course, the next question is, the gacha system good? Now, of course, I do think it has a lot of merit to it from the alpha that I played and from the conversations that I've had in meetings. There is a lot of improvements with gacha in general, but you know, I think as I played the game through the alpha, it was an extremely fun experience. There is somewhat of a sticker slash stamp system, much like maybe something like Genshin, where you will have things that you've summoned for, as well as the character that may be concluded. But again, I don't know if it's going to be the same, as well as another question that I had. Well, will there be summoning animations? As of playing the game and as of currently, there was no summoning animations. It is going to have a summoning animation. I just couldn't tell you what that looks like. And I hope that that is something that is implemented within the beta. Future plans for the game, from what you know, along with the inclusion of PvP content, and they are taking that in mind for the release. Again, I don't think there is going to be a PvP within the beta release at all, or in the game whatsoever. Again, I don't really know. It wasn't really something that was talked about that much, but I assume if people want it, then they will probably add it. Because here's the thing, and I do think they will add it. I think from my personal experience, I do think, you know, especially when with games such as One Piece, I do think it can be done. I just don't know how it's going to be done. So if you guys want PvP, hit the comment section down below, spam them, tell them you want the PvP. Does the dodge slash dash have a timer? Are players able to abuse it freely? The answer is no, there is a cooldown, as far as, again, from the alpha, that there is a dash cooldown. You can't abuse it, and it's the same with the counter mechanic, or the Fugatsu block, the block mechanic. There is somewhat of a, you can't really abuse that either, but it's not that punishable. There is, you know, you can use it within a fast amount of time, just not spammed, which I would imagine you guys are talking about. In the trailer, when you see that purple-ish effect on the monsters or whatever, that's when you are able to use your block counter mechanic, and that is how there is certain conditions with certain levels about that mechanic in general, which makes it always fun and free and something you can't really abuse, but something you also have to time extremely correctly as well. So I guess, you know, maybe it's a bad or sacrilege to say this, but it's almost a little bit like Elden Ring or like a Souls game. It is very, or Sekiro, very specific, and you have to make sure you hit it at the right time, and it is valuable to the game itself, and it is something you need to really be good at to proceed sometimes through the story or to get your stars at the end of a mission. Is it going to be like BBS, where we have like 50 variations of Ichigo with different rarities? The answer to that is we'll have to wait to see how the game progresses. I do think, as I said, the game is focusing way more on the actual story itself. So, but then again, Ichigo has so many forms in general. So can you really blame BBS? And would I blame Soul Resonance? No. But after the story, who knows where the lead of the game will go? It could be the case, but I don't think the gacha system or the banners will be as as much as BBS offers. I do think it's probably going to be one or two a month, and you know, you'll have to see. Will it have a pity system? Again, it has been talked about. Me and Aaron really much did talk about it within calls and feedback. So hopefully, you know, that does get taken on board. Now, to end off this video, I know that there's probably a lot of questions, but I had to be very realistic in terms of just what I can answer. But I will say personally, and there is going to be another video very, very soon about this game as well. But I do want to really push the fact that please sign up to this game, support it, show some love, show that there is an audience for Bleach games in general. But I will say that the team in general involved in this, I can't give them praise enough, is that they do care. They're asking for feedback from the loyalist fans on the platforms imaginable, from many different languages to many different regions of the world. There's always questions. You know, Kubo's in it, he signed off on it, he's happy with it, and the team are very much working night and day trying to make sure this game is as good as it can be, especially down to the art. I mean, there were some people that were complaining about Ichigo's sword being, you know, having that black kind of line on the sword. You know, like if you're a forger, you'd know that that's kind of like an oil burn thing. Anyway, I'm not going to get into blacksmith technicalities. But yes, people were complaining about that because in the anime, it was basically all silver. But in this game, it is black. And that is because, you know, and I'll show a picture on screen from the art book, Kubo actually drew it like this, and this is how it was originally supposed to look. The anime kind of, you know, the OG anime, like it always did, had a lot of imperfections or incorrections as well. So that's how it's originally supposed to look. And that's what they're doing with Bleach, is that they're making sure everything down to the color of the reishi, down to the colors of the swords, are absolutely on point. Now, as far as the story goes, it is going to be going up to the Soul Society, maybe in the beta as well. So you will be able to play all the way up to the Soul Society and play against Kenpachi, play against Byakuya, and I can't wait to see what your guys' reactions are truly going to be to that, as well as the special missions as well. So go support the game. I think it's an amazing game, and I can't wait for you guys to play it, and we're going to stream it as much as we can, we're going to talk about it as much as we can, and get excited, because Soul Resonance, probably going to be the best anime game out there. Because, I mean, look, it looks better than the Jujutsu Kaisen Bandai game for PlayStation. I'm sorry, it just does. Like, look, even if you want to say the models are slightly better, right, because it's on, like, a better console. Here's the thing, right, for a mobile game of this caliber to look even remotely close to any anime game on a PlayStation or an Xbox console speaks volumes about the intensity that they want to make this game look. And it does look good. No one can deny that. And to be honest with you, I think shame on Bandai. I hope that every game company looks at this game and is like, do you know what, man? They've absolutely smashed this. And that's the difference between a rushed game, something that you put out just for the sake of sales, compared to a game that has a lot of love and a lot of dedication. And that's the thing. Even this video, the devs will look at the comments. So write something nice, write something you want, and give them the feedback that they need. And of course, when the beta comes out, enjoy the beta and give the team everything that they need to do to make a good game for when the release comes out. With that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Been handsome as always, people. Peace out.